Hey, shalom. 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 And it's the brother, Ma'ab Qadar, from the Great Millstone Camp here in Cleveland. Back with another lesson. Lord willing, it's edifying. First and foremost, I would love to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rekah, Qadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone who taught us this truth. Blessings and safety to the men, women, and children that believe on the name Yahabah Shem Yahweh Shah and truth and sincerity. To you, I say shalom. Okay? And, you know, I'm going to title this lesson New Management Coming Soon. New management coming soon. Okay? And, you know, because, hey, man, the earth is, you know, being managed by, you know, Esau Edom. Okay? Yahweh, Wah, Yahweh Shai, they own the earth. Okay? And as owners of the earth, they set up management. Okay? And, you know, due to our, you know, transgressions and, you know, due to our iniquities, we're not in that management position right now. And the scriptures say, I have seen servants upon a horse and princes, you know, walking the earth as servants. Okay? And, hey, let's open up with the book of Job. All right, this is the book of Job, chapter 9, verse 24. The earth is given unto the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof, if not where, and who is he? Okay? And my grandma loved to say that, you know, every, you know, nation of people have wicked people amongst that nation. Okay? Yes, Jake loves wickedness, man. But the Lord hath created a wicked nation, the seed of the wicked. Okay, yeah, Jake are really righteous people, okay? But, you know, Jake, they live in wickedness, man. They follow after these heathens, man, and that's where the wickedness come in at, okay? They turn their back on the laws of Yahabah, Shem Yahweh Shah. They turn they back on their power, man, and that's when the wickedness comes in at, man. You know? You have a wicked nation, okay? Now, let's go to the book of Malachi 1 and 4. It says, whereas Edom, okay? Who is Edom? You Edomites, okay? It says, whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down. And they shall call them the border of wickedness. And the people against whom the Lord have an indignation forever. Okay, so the Lord will always have a beef, man, or a righteous anger towards you damn Edomites. Now, it's talking about the whole nation, man. Okay, this is the book of Genesis. Because you got to go scripture upon scripture, line upon line. Precept upon precept, man, because, you know, these people, they just don't get it, man. You know, they say, oh, no, the Lord was talking about Esau himself, you know, not the whole nation of Edom. You know, that's not biblical, man. Okay, this is the book of Genesis, chapter 36, verse 8. Thus dwelt Esau in Mount Seir. Esau is Edom. So you Edomites are that, you know, that wicked nation that has the earth right now, who's managing the earth right now, and you're destroying it. You are destroying it, man. Okay? And you know, if you want to play, you know, process of elimination, okay, Job 9 and 24 says the earth is given unto the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. What nation of people are responsible for covering up the faces of the judges, man? First and foremost, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah, man. Yahweh being the Heavenly Father and His Son, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. Okay, Yahweh Shai. There are two so-called black people. But in a society, they have crucified the images of our Lord and Savior and our Heavenly Father. All right, they have them pictures painted of two so-called devils. Two devils, man. All right, the nation of Israel, you got those gutter rats over there, Amalek over there in our land, occupying our land as if they're the children of the Most High, man. Who's responsible for that? You damn Edomites. Ham is not responsible for that. Ishmael is not responsible for that. Moab is not responsible for that. Ammon is not responsible for that. You damn devils, man. Okay? Let's go to the book of Sirach. This is the book of Sirach, chapter 10. Verse 1, it says, a wise judge will instruct his people, and the government of a prudent man is well ordered. As the judge of the people is himself, so are his officers, and what manner of man the ruler of a city is, such are all they that dwell therein. And who's the ruler? Who's the ruler of the earth right now? As we just, read, this devil. Okay? Esau, Edom. These elites, okay? And this is why the whole earth is wicked, okay? Because of the ruler of this earth. Okay? This is why, murder is at an all-time high. This is why our food is poisoned and touched and is just defiled, man. This is why you got masses of the people eating pork, shrimp, crab, and lobster. This is why adultery is at an all-time high. This is why there's no, truth in this land, man. This is why the woman is over the man in this society, man. This is why you can't enjoy your children, man. This is why, sickness exists. High blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, cancer. Okay, this is why, two men is able to walk up the street and skip and hold hands. This is why. Because of this devil. This is why robbery and theft is at an all-time high. This is why when you get paid from your job, you right back to square one after paying all your bills, man. This devil is the reason why, man. This is why Jake, getting gunned down in the streets and, this is why the whole system is corrupt, man. Because of this devil, man. The scriptures say he is as death, man. And he's ultimately going to be the reason why two-thirds of Jake is destroyed. Okay? This is Sirach 10 and 3. An unwise king destroyeth his people. Esau is destroying his people. These elites are destroying other people, man. Like I said, you niggas is actually following after this devil, man. He is leading you to that destruction, man. It says a unwise judge. Ain't nothing wise about this devil, man. Okay, the Lord didn't set this devil up to be a wise king. Okay, he set him up to be an unwise king. Okay, because this devil doesn't establish the law in this society. He doesn't establish righteousness in this society. He doesn't know righteousness. Okay? And this is how you know the Lord didn't set this devil up to rule forever. Okay, that's why the scriptures say the Lord have set a bound which he cannot pass. This devil is not going to get a pinky toe over that mark, man. Okay? But this is Sirach 10 and 4, it says the power of the earth is in the hand of the Lord. Okay, the owners of the earth, they have the power. Okay, Esau is about to be fired, man, and new management is about to take over. Okay, but it says the power of the earth is in the hand of the Lord, and in due time he will set over it one that is profitable, man. And who's that one that is profitable, man? Okay, Yahweh Shai, man. That's what Yahweh Shai is coming to do, man. He's coming to take the crowns from the kings of the earth, man. And he's coming to establish righteousness. Okay, and right behind Yahweh Shai, it's going to be us tribes, man. The people you see here on this sign, man. The Lord is going to put us back in authority. Okay? Let's go to the book of 2 Esdras. Chapter 6, verse 8. It says, and he said unto me, from Abraham unto Isaac, when Jacob and Esau were born of him, Jacob's hand held first the heel of Esau. Okay, and that was symbolic of us pulling these devils out of power. This is prophecy, man. This is not something that's just going to come about, man. This were written in the scriptures for it to happen. These devils being took out of power, and we are witnessing that right now in this lifetime. Okay? Verse 9, for Esau is the end of the world, man. That world going back to Eon, which means an age, a rulership. This devil's ruling right now. This is the end of the age, man. It says, for Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning that followeth, man. Which Jacob represents you tribes right here, man. You so-called blacks, Latinos, Hispanics, Native and Seminole Indians, man. You are those tribes that's starting with Yahweh Shai, man. You are those tribes that are about to rule. Which I am a part of those tribes, and Lord willing, I endure to the end to see the fall of this devil, man. Lord willing, I endure to the end to, you know, sit on the chariot, man, and watch you niggas burn. Okay? Back in the book of Sirach, chapter 10, verse 8. Because of unrighteous dealings, injuries, okay? This devil, unrighteous dealings, man. This devil, man, hey, in all actuality, he's every nation's enemy. Okay? He's everybody's enemy, okay? First and foremost, he's the number one enemy of the nation of Israel. But hey, man, the Lord didn't set this devil up to conduct good business with no one, man. He only cares about himself, man. And he doesn't even care about his own people. The scriptures say, he that is evil to himself, to whom will he be good? The scriptures say, if he doeth any good, he doeth it unwillingly, and at the last, he would declare his wickedness, man. Okay? The scriptures say, because of unrighteous dealings, man. You know? This devil rewarding people evil for good. Okay? The oppression. The scriptures say he covet fields and take them by violence. He destroy a man in his house, even a man in his heritage. You know, this devil, he assigned a treaty with you. Okay? And then he violate that treaty. Okay? Injuries, man. Look at the injuries that he have laid upon our nation, man. He destroyed us, man. You know, it's so many things that this devil have done unto us, and we just know a small portion of what this devil have done unto us, man. But let's talk about even with the other nations, how this devil has went around the earth dropping bombs on people just to fulfill his greed, man. He have murdered people just to fulfill his greed. The injuries, man. This devil have shed blood from one end of the earth to the other. Unrighteously, man. This devil don't kill, because kill is according to the scriptures, according to the law of the Bible. This devil murders, man. Okay? This devil commits murder, man. Okay? But it says, I'm going to start it over. Sirach 10 and 8, because of the unrighteous dealings, the injuries, and the riches got by deceit, the kingdom is translated from one people to another. Okay? The kingdom is about to be translated from one people to the other. And who's the other? The nation of Israel, starting with Yahawashi, man. Okay, let's skip down to 10. The physician cutteth off a long disease, and he that is today a king, tomorrow shall die. And who's that physician? Okay, that physician is Yahawashi. Hey, the scriptures also say in, the book of Psalms, I have seen the wicked in great power and spreading himself like a Green Bay tree. Okay, that cancer has spread it around the four corners of the earth. So the Lord has to cut off that cancer, man. Okay, cut it off. Okay, because, hey, Esau is the cancer, man. He's that long disease. Okay? And, you know, he's the reason why the whole earth is mourning right now. But guess what? That mourn is going to turn to rejoice and joy. Okay? Because, hey, you know, we could talk about, you know, why it's, you know, people starving on earth. Why are, you know, people homeless on earth? You know, why is majority of the people sick? Okay? Why this and why that? But the solution is to take this devil out of power, man. Okay? And that'll stop all issues. This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 29, verse 2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. And no one's rejoicing right now, man. Gas prices are high. They're going to continue to be high. You know, this devil is about to, you know, come down having great wrath, because he know that his time is short. Okay? Proverbs 29 and 2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. But when the wicked bear rule, the people mourn. And that's what's going on right now. The world is mourning. Okay? But guess what? Yahabah Shimei Awashah is about to set up one that is righteous. Okay? And that's, once again, talking about the nation of Israel. The people here on this sign, man. Starting with Yahawashi. Okay? And, you know, matter of fact, I'm going to close with a quick precept, if I can find it real quick. Just bear with me. This is 2nd Ezra, chapter 4 and 29. If there that which is sown be not turned upside down, and if the place where the evil is sown pass not away, then cannot it come that is sown with good. So the Lord has to turn this place upside down, man. He has to destroy this place in order for what is sown with good to come about. And that is the kingdom. Okay? That is the kingdom. Okay? And the kingdom is close. Shalom.